the beach. It was getting late afternoon, so people wandered back to camp to get ready for supper. This is beautiful Benson Lake, carved out by the glaciers in ancient times. Well, there's Glen Dawson in the middle of the picture, and here's Ansel Adams hamming it up, as he always liked to do in those times. Cathedral Peak is quite a prominent point southwest of Tuolumne Meadows. It's a very sharp-looking mountain from the meadows. Here is Cathedral Lake. Well, a group of us went up to Cathedral Lake, Cathedral Peak, one day to climb it. It has the main top and three pinnacles. So we picked on this pinnacle first. I was perched with my camera on a tripod and a telephoto lens on a ledge right in the middle of it all. The people there were Lewis Clark in the light shirt, Glen Dawson, and Jules Eichorn. Roping down is accomplished by hanging both ends of the rope down to the bottom of the descent and putting the loop at the top around a rock. You're supposed to be able to, when you get to the bottom, let go of one end and pull on the other, and the rope will go right around that rock and come down. But in this case, it didn't go right around. It stayed up there. So we had to climb back up again and loosen it, and then come down a different direction. Well, we'll start off now going down the north side instead of the east side. The highest point of Cathedral Peak is a more or less flat surface. It slopes to the northeast about 15 degrees, but it's nice and flat at least, and not too difficult to get to. Here's Lewis Clark coming down. Now we'll go to the third pinnacle, no, the second pinnacle, and here's a demonstration of two ways of going up and down a thing like this. Glen Dawson there in the light shirt will climb up to the top, and then when he comes down, he will climb down, putting his weight on his fingers and toes and supporting himself that way. The rope is there only as a safety measure in case he slipped or a ledge broke off under him. Now this is climbing down. Thank you. The only difficulty with this method of travel is that it's hard to see below your feet. Different from reaching up and climbing up where you watch where your hands are. Now Jack Wrigglehuss will climb the same pinnacle. He will climb up as Glen did, but he will come down by roping down, putting his full weight on the rope. This is the third pinnacle. These pinnacles had no names when the pictures were taken. They may have names now, but I don't know what they are. This is Glen Dawson again. Glen, incidentally, is the son of Ernest Dawson, who was president of the club long ago. Well, back to camp with the usual camp duties. Preparing food, mainly, is the big thing. Getting firewood. There's plenty of dead wood that was in the forest at that time. It had been collecting for centuries. So we'd cut the big logs into smaller lengths. Then we'd split up the short pieces. Sometimes we'd split the big logs first if they were rotted badly enough. There was a great deal of cleaning of pots and pans, as well as the preparation of food. Here's Virginia Adams, that's Ansel Adams' wife. And these people couldn't get started the right way, as you see. But they did, finally. This is Ansel again.